Good evening. Here in Columbia, Missouri, after last Saturday's big Mizzou win over Oklahoma, you may have thought there'd be nothing else to talk about all week, but there is a lot of talk throughout the entire state of Missouri after 30 people arrested for trespassing amidst thousands for going down on the field during that big victory celebration. Before the football game even officially ended, fans swarmed the field celebrating Mizzou's win over Oklahoma. Authorities appear to arrest this fan right in front of our cameras as others flood the field.
For the first, minute, I was literally in, a state of shock. I was handcuffed.
Now facing the potential of a criminal record, this Mizzou student doesn't want to be on camera, but showed us his trespassing citation for going onto the field after the game. He says he went with the forward motion of the pushing crowd, trying to stay safe, surrounded by thousands.
So I was shrugging my shoulders, saying, "Why don't you arrest that guy? Why don't you arrest that guy?" He said, "I don't have 3,000 pairs of handcuffs," or something like that.
We caught up with one local lawmaker as he went to meet with university officials about what happened. He says the potential punishment doesn't fit the crime.
My issue is that rather than charge these kids with a Class B misdemeanor and give them a criminal record, why not step up, exercise some reasonable discretion on behalf of the university, give them some form of community service in exchange for dropping the charges so they don't have that record?
Some students say it's a double standard, people facing punishment for rushing the field while the university sells pictures of students rushing the field.
Every student that held a season ticket pass to the football games got an email from the university that said, buy these photos. You can get them framed, everything you want. And one of them was of students rushing the field.
A spokesperson for the athletic department tells us that photograph has been pulled from the website and is no longer being sold. In the meantime, the students are waiting to see what will happen to them. In Columbia, Michele Rooney, KMBC 9 News.